It's another Sunday night. Thank you for joining us. And to my wonderful father, happy Father's Day.
Hey, happy Father's Day, handsome.
Wow, you call your dad handsome?
Of course I call my dad handsome. Okay, it was my birthday. He texted me before prettiest Jackie, something like that, from your handsomest fan.
Ah, how nice.
I really call him handsome.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, mine's awesome na lang.
Oh, awesome.
Happy Father's Day to all the wonderful fathers out there. We would be nothing without you, especially me. Yeah.
And you know, my husband Mark, he asks me, "Oh, what's your present for me? It's Father's Day." And I say to him, "Why? Are you my father?"
Oh nga.
So when it's Mother's Day, if I say, "Oh, anong regalo mo sa akin?" He'll say, "Bakit? Are you my mother?" Oh, ganyan. But so, anyway, happy Father's Day, Mark.
Give him something small na lang, some token.
I already have, no?
Okay, what did you give him? Secret.
Four t-shirts.
Four, why four? Why four?
Wala, because...
There's some relevance with four.
Four?
Four is the number of kids
I
you
heart
wanted
you
to have.
Pare.
Yuck. Anyway.
That's the show of my dad.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I heart you pare.
Well, you know what? Speaking of fathers, our guest for tonight is actually a father too.
Ah.
Yeah, so we have to greet him also.
Happy Father's Day to our guest.
Yes, and his father... Well, I think he also took after his father.
His father's a friend of my father. So to his father, happy Father's Day.
He's a friend also of my father.
Oh, okay.
So it's a Father's Day.
Yes.
Yes.
And?
And I really, another, well, like 4-4 father is Jose Rizal. Happy birthday to him too.
I know. It's his birthday. Eh. Yeah, 150.
Tandaan na niya sana, no?
Actually, not so.
Oh, yeah, he looks young pa eh. 150?
But he never grew old. I never saw him old.
Parang tumangkad pa nga siya today eh. I'll tell you why later.
150 years.
150 mm-hmm. years.
That's why tomorrow is a holiday.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Is it?
Yes.
I wouldn't know.
It's a holiday tomorrow.
Yeah. So when we come... Wait.
Oh, she...
Hold on.
Yeah, okay.
So what did you say about our guest? You said... she said she doesn't think we're going to run out of good-looking public servants. Is that what you said?
Yes. Yeah.
To guests. Yes. Yeah.
Especially in Congress.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Diba? Dime a dozen. Dami-dami na nila.
And she said that he is one of the eligible... Congressman?
Yeah. Since the 13th Congress.
Since the 13th Congress.
He's laughing, oh.
Why is he laughing?
It's complicated. Why is he laughing?
Okay, are we going to ask him why?
Yeah, let's ask him why.
He keeps laughing.
Let's ask him why now.
No, later.
Okay. When we come back, so don't you go away. You don't want to miss this.
She said, and tonight we have a guest from the 2nd District of Laguna. He's going to talk about the 150th birthday of our national hero, Jose Rizal. And we are also going to talk about why he was laughing when I said he was eligible and he was laughing. So we're going to talk about that. First, he said, don't ask me anything about it. But since he laughed, we are going to ask him.
We're just going to ask him why he laughed. That's all.
Yeah, that's all.
You know, so, friendly conversation.
So, ladies and gentlemen, it is our pleasure to have with us tonight, Timmy Chipeco.
Good evening.
Hello,
Jackie.
Good evening.
Good evening, cutie.
Justin Timmy Chipeco from the 2nd District of Laguna.
Yes. Yeah. So you have been a congressman for how
well,
long?
It's my last term in Congress.
Oh, your last term
already? Yes, I got elected in 2004 during the 13th Congress.
He was almost the youngest then. It was just a matter of months.
Yeah.
Oh.
I was 29 years old.
And who was the youngest then?
Well, it was actually Joel Villanueva, Secretary of
Hi, Tesla. Joel. Yeah. Just by a few months. But then they turned out to be best friends, so that's okay.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay, so you shared it anyway.
Yes.
The two best friends, the two youngest
best friends
in Congress. And what are your plans after the next 2 years?
Well, so far I like to finish my term, you know, mm-hmm. and I'll decide when I get to the point when I really have to decide.
Your father,
I'll make a
my
fearless
political,
forecast.
Political career would
because his
would
dad's
go.
Also on his third term as mayor. So I'm making a fearless forecast
that you exchange.
Yeah, why not?
Well, I mean, I'm not gonna deny or confirm it right now.
So. Okay, so we will confirm it for you. So you can exchange, and then after one term, you can decide if you like the new posts or if you go back to your.
We'll see.
Posts.
You know, that's just it. He has a really good point of view when it comes to that. Mm-hmm. He thinks, never mind.
But you know what some people do?
Do you want to share your point of view?
About what?
No, he thinks that if he, at least first case, will take another position, he intends to finish the whole 9 years.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So you do 9 and you do another 3 terms.
I believe when you're given a position, you have to do as much as you can in that position. So it's like, not a flip-flopping because of convenience or because of, you know. So if ever I'll be going into one position, then I would rather stay until the term would end.
Yes. So not just for all 3 terms that you can run for.
Yes.
Just not something like a transient thing.
Yeah, not something because of political convenience. Yes. No? You would exchange terms and then that's it. And you go back to your original post.
Yes. So
to me, I would like to finish everything.
How is your dad enjoying, since your dad was congressman before and then he's mayor now? What do you think he's enjoying more? Have you ever
the responsibility is greater when you're handling an executive position. And I think whenever every person given the chance would really have to work hard for it, you know. And it comes with also enjoying the job, you know. Because if you don't really enjoy being in politics, then you shouldn't go into it in the first place.
Yes.
Happy Father's Day to your father.
Happy Father's Day.
We greeted him. Yeah, happy Father's Day.
Yeah.
Okay. Incidentally, he knows your dad.
I know. You know my dad.
Yeah, we were together in the 13th Congress. Mm-hmm. Where we were sitting beside each other, so I kind of know him a lot.
Wait. Why were you sitting beside each other? Isn't it by region?
No, because during that time, you were members of the minority group.
Oh,
so when you're part of the minority, you have this certain small area there.
So
you
sit
in the
front,
plenary.
First row.
Yeah, in the first
row. You sit together, but it's not alphabetically arranged?
No, it's not. It's not.
No, it's always by region.
Yeah.
You know, most of the people I meet these days, they're either friends of my father in Congress, and they're mostly young. And I'm like, okay. And, you know, and they say that my dad gives all these jokes and that. I know what they mean.
Oh, yeah? Is it true?
I can't forget those jokes.
Okay, for example,
I cannot tell those jokes here in your show.
I know.
Really funny.
Very, very funny.
If you can't tell those jokes here, that means it's MTRCB.
Yeah, maybe.
You would rate it differently.
Something that the boys would enjoy.
Does he give jokes like that around you guys?
Oh, yeah!
All the time?
Yeah, the others are from me.
Okay.
No, but he's fun.
So now I know where it comes from.
If it's funny, it's from Jackie. Mm-hmm.
So I was thinking earlier, it's amusing the way like the mayor and the vice mayor exchange. The mayor goes down to being vice mayor and the vice mayor goes up. Then after maybe one term, they exchange again. But these are really people who are friends because some people from the vice mayor's position, they go up to mayor, and then they suddenly realize that they like this, and
they
don't give it
back. That's not true all the time, huh? In fact, a lot of times, the one who runs for mayor, coming from a vice mayor position after one term, will actually go up against the mayor, and that's
exactly why. Yeah. So I have met people like in Region 7. I have met people who are friends.
Yeah.
I mean, when they say they're only going to do it for one term, they only do it for one term, and then they work well together. So the mayor and the vice mayor don't really go against each other.
That's why, in my case, I haven't really decided on it yet. No?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's what most people would think, that we would just exchange with my dad. But actually, the truth is that I really haven't thought about it. You know, I also plan of going to my own public private lives. You know?
You're a lawyer.
I'm a lawyer by profession.
Okay.
You know? I'm practicing also my law career.
Mm-hmm.
You know? I have a law firm.
tell everybody out here what your first job was.
Well, my first job was really, I was selling encyclopedias. So.
No, the real first job. No, that's not his first job.
Okay.
Were you working in the regional trial court? Where were you working?
No, I was working, I had a chance also to work with the House Electoral Tribunal as a staff, of course, with my dad. So I was doing some election cases, or research on election cases. But I didn't really think about it. Then it's my second term also with the HRET now as a member of the commission. So
okay, when you were working for your father, did you want that job? Did he offer it to you? Did you enjoy it?
Well, I think that time I just took my bar exam, mm-hmm. so I was waiting for my results. So I didn't anything. I have nothing to do. So yes. it was offered to me.
And he said, "Oh, dun ka pa na sa opisina."
Yeah, that's it. So I did some research. You know, mm-hmm. I even went through the process of doing all the nitty gritty works. You know, and it gave me some experience in the law practice, mm-hmm. you know, especially in election cases.
Okay.
And then after that, I was offered to run for congressman. So there now I'm here.
Did you like that right away? I mean, was it something you really thought about before that, you know, maybe someday I would like to run for Congress?
Probably someday, but not at that time. Mm-hmm. No, not at 29 years old, just finished the bar, you know. Yeah. So I wasn't really expecting that I would be running for Congress. Mm-hmm. I wanted to run for board member probably that time in 2004, but Congress was really out of my league, so to speak. And then, you know, a lot of changes would, you know, opportunities would come in. Sometimes it's not within your reach, you know. It would just come in and you just have to grab it, you know. Mm-hmm. It's there. So I decided to run, and there I am.
But, you know, Tims, I wouldn't really worry about you running for mayor and your dad running for Congress only because, you know, because what you do is you run and the people vote. So it's really the votes that will speak anyway. So it doesn't matter what position you run for because we have a democratic society.
Yeah.
So go ahead and run for mayor and we got your back. So we'll be hearing more of Timmy in a little bit. She said, kasama natin si Congressman Justin Timmy Chipeco. Tell us about the 150th birthday of Jose Rizal and the unveiling that you did this morning with the president.
Yeah, what time did you start?
Well, we have a ceremony in the morning and also in the afternoon. In the morning, there is a flag ceremony. So, in giving respect to our national hero, at the same time, this morning, we unveiled the tallest Rizal Monument.
How tall is that?
It's done by your dad, right? The mayor, Chipeco.
Yeah, we planned it. We bought the property in front of the municipal building, and mm-hmm. we converted it into a park. No? And in that park, we built the around 22 to 23 feet of the statue of Rizal in commemoration to his 150th birthday, and mm-hmm. also being a townmate, because, you know, everyone knows Rizal is from Calamba City.
Yes, yes.
So, that's what we did this morning. Because we already thought that you go around the world, no? You would see that there's different Rizal shrines around the world.
Yes, mm-hmm. like at least 5 different parts of the world.
Yes, they have Rizal shrines around the world. And when you go to his hometown in Calamba, there's nothing. We have the house and a small Rizal monument, mm-hmm. no? So we thought that it's about time for us to build something, to give real respect to our national hero. It's also, in our case, it's a townmate. So
yes.
We're proud of him. So that's why we built this monument to commemorate.
It's the tallest Rizal monument. How high is it?
It's, I think, around 22 to 23 feet.
How long did your dad plan this whole thing?
Well, we planned it for a year, you know. We planned it for a year. More than a year.
But you celebrate Rizal's birthday every year.
Yes.
But this is the first time you're...
It's really big because...
This is the time.
This is the 150th birthday.
Yes. And the center of the celebration was done in Calamba City mm-hmm. this morning.
Okay, what is the monument made out of? What material?
I'm not really so sure.
Recyclable? No, just kidding.
I forgot the name of the... There's really a sculptor who did it. No, mm-hmm. I forgot his name. It's my dad who really talked about him. But in the afternoon, we had this parade. You know, we have floats depicting the life of Rizal. So there's also
and you were
theme.
On the float portraying...
Yes.
Thank you for being here on time tonight, huh?
I know. Yeah. You had such a busy day. Yeah, I know.
Yeah, but we do this every year. So... We celebrate his birthday every year. It's more, June 19th for us, is more of a celebration than in December 30th.
Oh, I never knew that.
Yeah, that's why when I was also in Congress in the last term, I filed a bill to make it a national holiday. But right. There's also some controversy coming up whether or not we should celebrate the birth of Rizal or the death of Rizal. Mm-hmm. So So that's it, no? It's still pending in Congress.
That's
so
true. And another bill that you would like to file is the 5-year term for congressmen. Ah, no.
5 years straight.
No, yeah, because like in Singapore, they have a term.
Singapore's like four,
for 5 years.
5 years.
And they only meet once a month. I mean, yeah, when they heard about how often we meet, they were like surprised.
Once a month? Once Not a even month. Once a week?
Once a month.
Wow.
Can you believe that?
No, but I was talking to some parliamentarians in other countries, you know, because sometimes you get invited.
Yes.
And then sometimes we would talk, would ask each other, oh, how long is your term? Some would say we're 4 years, 5 years, but never did they heard about the three years.
Yes.
Because they're telling us 3 years is too short.
It really is.
It really is.
It is.
That's why in the Committee on Constitutional Amendments, which also I'm a member, I would like to suggest that if ever there would be any amendments to the Constitution, that the term limits would be extended a little bit and to have lesser elections.
Mm-hmm. That's true. Because it's so expensive too.
Because it's the same thing, you know. You have 3 years, you have three elections. So at a total of 9 years. Mm-hmm. So might as well, you know, why not have 4 years and two elections? Mm-hmm. Maybe just lower 1 year or 5 years, two elections. So that is 10 years. Mm-hmm. Just a difference of 1 year, you know,
yes.
Plus or minus. So.
Right.
But in effect, the expenses that would be saving, you know, the savings that we'll be getting is much greater if we have only two elections. So I think that's one of the political reforms that we should also do in case that, you know, the president decides to make a decision to amend also the Constitution, other than the economic provisions that we have to also amend. No?
Anyway, that's applicable for the next, if ever, di ba?
Yeah,
it's not the one meant for
us.
In
my case, it's my
terms.
Last term, so I don't really mind.
Yes,
no?
Yes.
But for you to push for it.
I think it's really, we really have to push for that because it will really benefit the future generations now. You know, I've been in Congress for the last 7 years. I've seen, you know, a lot of things there also, you know. I've been with the minority, now I'm in the majority group. So I know the problems or the ins and outs of Congress. And I see that one of the greatest, well, hindrance to our development is also having too many elections. Mm-hmm. You know, like in the same year, you have the national elections.
Barangay.
At the same time, you have the barangay elections.
Yes, yes.
And then after 2 years, you know, people start campaigning and talk about elections again.
It's nonstop.
No,
it's
no, that's
nonstop
true.
Cycle.
You know, the last year of their terms, they usually really focus on the elections already.
Yes,
they don't really
yes.
focus on what they're supposed to do.
And that's a political reality we have to face. I mean, of course, QT is now also a member of Congress. Your dad was a colleague of mine in the 13th Congress. And these are all what people are talking about, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I know people would be fed up in talking about elections, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a reality that we have to face, you know, because of the current system that we have.
Yeah, the elections here in the Philippines is like
a
fiesta.
It's a huge thing, right?
No, it's like a big party.
Seriously, 1 year
and everybody,
before, everyone's talking about it.
Everybody gets into it, and everybody has their own manok, and they're always like meeting.
And the colors,
I mean, like,
oh my God, the streets.
And whatever color you wear, it means
awayan ng color.
Talaga, like,
dalawang
napili
ng color.
Bakit suot ka na yan? Bakit?
Oh,
why are you wearing that? Why
yung
you wearing
mga
that?
Ninuno ko, naunang magsuot ng color ganito,
talaga?
Ganyan.
I
diba?
Play badminton and I'm not wearing yellow. Oh, but di ka na kay yellow, especially if it's orange. Or
me, I have to wear all blue. Like, wala na akong binili kung hindi blue. Diba?
It's
blue
really,
ng blue.
You know, sometimes elections are really funny here in the Philippines because even the color would make a political statement.
Seriously, you can't make a public appearance wearing the wrong color. Or you'll,
no, but that's true. The whole,
especially if you're the candidate.
The whole time, 2010, the whole time until election day, I really never wore any of the colors of the other.
Yeah, you
except
make
for,
sure.
Except
any
for,
other. Sige na lang, lavender.
Yeah.
Sige, go. Diba?
Yeah, lavender. Oh.
Peach. Just nothing that can look like the colors of any other person.
That's true.
Well, I think this to show that somehow we're still a political,
what was your color?
Political young society, you know.
I was
and,
orange pala.
Yeah, I think we're still a political young society, you know, even though we're not more into sometimes into issues, you know. We're into the you know that we're talking about a lot of, you know, the lives of every politician.
Yes,
but
yes.
not really on the issues that they're really concerned
yes,
of,
yes.
you know. But which should concern us,
yeah.
diba? As Filipinos.
But not just us. Look at America and like Representative Wiener, right? I mean, I think it's
well, there's some few.
a few.
Yeah.
No, but
it's funny
he,
also.
He's kind of asking for it though. You know why?
Yeah.
I would have if I would have changed the pronunciation of my name if I had a name that was spelled that way.
No, but why if not it's Weiner? Really pronounced like that.
No, I would call I would call myself Weiner and make use of the people calling me Representative Weiner.
Yeah, but unless he likes the attention.
Exactly, because he even make jokes about
exactly.
it, right?
See, yeah. So he really uses that.
Well, so then we have to pause for a break.
Well, he got elected to it using
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Or he might be censored.
Or he might be censored. MTRCB in the house. Magbabalik po ang she said. Don't go away.
Nagbabalik po ang she said, and we are still with the congressman of the 2nd District of Calamba, Timmy Chipeco.
Who I had a hard time guessing. You know, I was asking him to guess from the 14th Congress, ayaw.
Eh, kasi naman, medyo manggagaling pa sa malayo. And especially today, no? Of all days to guess today, nanggaling pa siya ng Laguna. How long does it take to come here?
Well, since the expressway was already finished totally, yeah. It's around 30 minutes.
Only? Yeah. Oh, no wonder you made it on time.
From Makati. But going to here, to Quezon City, it will take another 30 minutes.
Okay, but how long did it take before the express?
Oh, my God. When they were building the Skyway mm-hmm. and everything, it took me like 2 to 3 hours going to Laguna.
Oh, that long?
Every day, yeah.
Yeah, but now it's much quicker. That's why he was able to make it. You know, recently, very recently, you know how we featured the panitas of Chris Locker in Pampanga?
Okay.
Remember? Yeah. We went there for our show?
Yes.
Recently, Timmy went to experience the panitas.
Oh, yeah. And you can eat that, right?
Yeah.
How many were you guys?
Oh, we were around five.
And they had 3 panitas.
Oh,
can
yeah,
you believe?
We wanted to go back for the fiesta.
It's all good. Well, QT was the one who recommended it to me. So, mm-hmm.
No, it's really the best pizza.
And I love eating.
The Philippines.
Oh, yeah, we do too. Yeah.
Did you expect the pizza to be that way?
No, I didn't know that you have to do those, you know, there's a ceremony before you can
really?
Eat it. You have to roll it, you know, with the
alfalfa
and, you know.
Isn't it really refreshing? It's like a different way of eating pizza. It's like you're having pizza but salad.
Yeah.
So if we go to Calamba, what are you going to feed us?
Oh, there's a lot of foods there.
Like?
Well, okay, since you love food, what would you feed food lovers?
Well,
since we're foodies.
Well, in my area, in the 2nd District, it's really 4 towns. So Calamba is just one of the towns. And
the other towns are?
Well, the other town is Cabuyao,
now
in Congress to become a city, you know, mm-hmm. spending now in Congress. And the other one is Los Baños.
Yes.
And the last one is Bae. Oh, it's Bay. No?
Bae. B-A-E?
B-A-Y. Yeah, they pronounce it Bae.
We just passed through their town when we did the DNR. Mm-hmm. Yeah, right?
Sure.
Our place is, it's more known to be a tourist destination because mm-hmm. of the hot springs. You know?
Yes.
Because our place is near the Mount Makiling, which is a volcano.
Yes. So, we were near there.
Yeah, because the hot springs are, the water there is abundant. Mm-hmm. So a lot of tourists would go there and, you know,
how many tours do you get a year?
Well, I really don't know because most of them would come from Metro Manila.
And they just drive in
and
out.
Batangas and just to go there and
get
the pool, now
it's
swim and then go
so
back.
So much closer to drive.
Yeah. Accommodations. Where do people stay?
There are so many resorts there.
Yeah, there are private resorts that you can rent, houses mm-hmm. that you can rent, and then for 12 hours or 24 hours. And there are also some public resorts that you can also use.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, people would go there, you know, bring their families, have picnics, and then mm-hmm. swim, and then later in the day, they'd go back to Manila.
Because it's so convenient.
So, yeah. Timmy, I'm still waiting.
Yeah, what are you going to feed us?
What are you going to feed us? I'm hungry.
Well, in Los Baños,
well,
one of the well-known...
He's hungry too. He hasn't eaten yet.
Yeah, a lot of people would go to buy the buko pie, you know.
Which is the
original. And all the stores there put the original.
Yes.
So, who's the original?
I know, all
okay,
of them.
We want to hear it from you. Who is the original? Since they all
No, they're all good. I can say that it's all of them are good. It's mm-hmm. just that, for example, there are some brands that also, but you have to buy on the stores themselves. You know,
yes.
So that you can get the fresh book.
Yes, yeah. So it's a little hot.
Yeah, it's hot and warm.
It's nice, you know, when you eat food, let's say from
espasol
Laguna.
Espasol is also
espasol or the buka pie. It's really good.
Before we had this the kinulob na itik. It's like duck.
What's that?
I like duck, that. Yeah.
Kinulob, like nakakulob na itik.
Yeah, they cook it in a way.
But fried, deep fried.
I'm not really sure how they cook it. It's just I eat it.
Wait, so, I like that.
Yeah. Oh, you like to heat your buko pie?
No. We actually had fried itik, and then itik, it has this like
sweet sauce,
like sweet sauce that's a little
like
anghang.
Peking duck.
Yeah. And then like I almost ate like after lunch. They brought the itik, and I had a second lunch. Yeah.
What's itik? Chick.
No,
chicken.
It's duck. Yeah, it's
a duck. It's like a small
it's a native,
duck.
Native duck.
And it's like it's all dark meat.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is.
I love
it's
it.
All good. It's all good.
And then for dessert, you can have your buko pie, which you want. How do you eat yours?
No, warm. You eat it. Oh, because when you bring it back to Manila, it's not usually, the same.
I wanted to put some ice cream on top.
What flavor? Vanilla.
Vanilla, yeah.
Wow, nice.
So that's how I like it, mine.
So next time you come and visit us on the show, you can bring fried itik.
Yeah. Sure.
Fried itik, akala ko you're gonna ask for buko pie.
No, you can give her the buko pie.
No, I don't like buko pie.
I like fried itik.
Yeah.
What else do you have in Laguna?
Espasol.
Well, we have the usual, you know, Tagalog dishes, you know.
Like?
Well, we have caldereta. We have
calderetang
like kambing.
Kambing?
Yeah.
Aso?
No, we don't. Okay. Or what I love most is the bulalo. You know, we have the bulalo.
Oh, so you like that also?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. The
bulalo is puchero to us.
Yeah, it's puchero to you.
To us. It's
puchero
in Cebu.
Yeah. Cebu. But this is bulalo, Manila.
Bulalo, yeah, Tagalog. Yes, Tagalog.
With the marrow and the laman inside.
Yeah, with everything. Yeah. And they like
the
cook it for
yards.
So many hours and the meat would just drop off.
Yeah.
That's called forever young soup.
So, Cutie was asking, do you cook?
You cook?
No. No, I
No, because there are a lot of people that like food like to cook.
Do you cook?
No.
You don't cook, the two of you?
I don't cook. Okay. I can microwave. Yeah. I can call for delivery.
I can try.
Yeah, I can also try.
I can call cooking. To make reservations. You can cook, right?
I try. No, but when I cook and I try, then everybody eats it because there's nothing else to eat.
That's good.
Yeah, so they eat it. Then they say, let's say, my adobo, what's this caldereta? No,
make sure they don't prepare anything else, but of course, too good. Like one time, I made like baked spaghetti, which my friend taught me in Ronquillo.
Okay.
I swear, nobody ate. It was actually good. They didn't even, so wala na. I said, sige, I won't cook na lang.
Why did they eat it?
I don't know. My mom, my dad, my brothers, they didn't even bother. They didn't even give me a chance.
No, me.
So that was the end of my cooking days.
You shouldn't cook any other food.
There was nothing else on the table, and they didn't eat it. They didn't even try it.
Drive-thru is okay.
I can't say anything about that.
Yeah, I know, right?
No, but usually, like, if you don't know how to cook, but you know how to eat, then you'll try to experiment on a certain
taste. Yeah, I would do that.
I do that, and then I add this, and I add that, and later on, it's good.
And if it tastes bad, I would be the one who know it. You know, I would share it to anyone first.
So, having been in Congress for 13th, 14th, and 15th Congress, what are there any, like, major differences that you've seen, or something distinct from a particular Congress that
is
non-existent?
Each Congress is distinct really from itself. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Like in the 13th Congress, when I started. No,
as one of the youngest?
Yeah, as one of the youngest. You have a different perspective. Of course, you're trying to, first, you have to study, you know, you have to keep quiet. And then later on, you're trying to learn the ins and outs of Congress. At the same time, you try to work with your constituencies. No. But there's really something to do also with the leadership of Congress, because I've gone to three speakers, you know. The first one was Speaker De Venecian, the second one was Speaker Nograles, and now it's Speaker Der Belmonte. And I see that they have their own style of leadership. Mm-hmm. I'm not saying who's better or who's not good. I'm just saying that each of them have a different style of leadership. And I think now our speaker is also doing very good, you know. That brings the institution also as a whole, no, it brings up the confidence of the people.
Mm-hmm.
Who is the leader? Because sometimes people would think, Congress, who's the